Hi guys, today we are breaking down macros, a little macro 101. I'm going to teach you how to figure out your own macro counts. What you need to know, macro stands for macronutrition. There are three macros, proteins, carbohydrates, and fats. Anytime you hear the term micronutrient, it means things like minerals, vitamins, antioxidants. Those are all part of your macronutrients. You potentially heard of IIFYM. It stands for if it fits your macros. IIFYM is macro dieting. It is flexible nutrition. Your body's percentage of macro needs is going to vary based on a variety of factors, but I'm going to give you the tools to calculate yours so that you're at our industry standard of 40-30-30 macros. That's 40% of your diet in carbohydrates, 30% of your diet in protein, and 30% of your diet in fats. Why not just count calories? You can lose weight if you're in a calorie deficit. However, being in calorie deficit does not necessarily mean that you have control over building muscle. Understanding your macros is going to help you not only lose weight if that's your goal, but it's also going to help you build lean muscle mass. Additionally, when you're focused on counting calories, you're generally not focused on the importance of the quality of the food that you're eating. So some pros and cons about macros, I would say the pros are that it helps you better understand how much of which food groups that you should eat to reach your physical goals, and it gives you more informed control over your food choices. Some cons: it does require you to calculate or to use an app that calculates your food. It requires you to weigh your food, and it may not be a sustainable practice for daily living if you're not trying to reach physical goals. An alternate approach to macros is using Portion Fix and Ultimate Portion Fix. These are both set to the macros ratio of 40-30-30, the industry standard, and they're containerized programs. So you use color-coded containers. Basically, it's set to your calorie target. You learn how much of each food group to eat, so you never really have to think about charting the way that you do with macronutrition. The pro of Portion Fix is it's super easy. So if you don't want to weigh your food, do any math, count calories, etc., I definitely support it. The con is that there is an eat this or eat that list. So if you eat off plan, it's a little bit harder to course correct. If you go over in your carbs, it's a little bit harder to figure out what other containers you need to take out to reach that ultimate goal of 40-30-30 macros. So let's get calculating. First thing that you need to know is that a gram of protein contains 4 calories, a gram of carbohydrates contains 4 calories, and a gram of fat contains 9 calories. So right away you can see, even though that fat is still going to be around 30% of your diet, you're going to be eating a much smaller amount of fat, because fat calories per gram are almost twice what a protein and a carbohydrate calorie per gram is. So I'm going to teach you how to do your basal metabolic rate. I'm going to teach you how to do your total daily energy expenditure, and then we're going to decide if you want to be in surplus or deficit. So pull out a calculator, and as we go through each area here, you can pause the video before you move on to the next. I want you to be getting these equations as you go. So first is your BMR. This is your basal metabolic rate. This is how many calories your body burns in a day doing nothing. This ranges person to person, but you can use this basic equation to figure out where you're at. There's one for women, there's one for women. For women, you need to take your weight in pounds, multiply it by 4.35. Set that number aside. You're going to take your height in inches, multiply that by 4.7. Set that number aside. You're gonna take both of those numbers, add them together, also add in another 655. Set that aside. Now you want to take your age in years. You want to multiply that by 4.7. That number you are deducting from the equation that you just got. So it's 655 plus 4.35 times your weight in pounds plus 4.7 times your height in inches minus 4.7 times your age in years. Hopefully that made sense. And there's a separate equation for men as well. That is your basal metabolic rate. Now let's calculate your TDEE. This is your total daily energy expenditure, because you're not sitting on your duff all day. So simple equation, you can use this to figure out where you're at. If you're lightly active, you're gonna say you're doing 1 to 3 days of exercise a week. You're gonna take your BMR, that number you just got, you're gonna multiply it by 1.375. Say you're very active, hard exercise 6 to 7 days a week, you're gonna take your BMR and multiply it by 1.725. So now you just need to decide if you want to be in surplus or deficit. So So to figure out your calorie target, do you want maintenance? Do you want weight loss? Do you want muscle and weight gain? For maintenance, your ideal calorie intake is simply your TDEE. So you do not want to be eating more than you're consuming, nor do you want to be eating less than you're consuming. So there's no deficit, there's no gain. Your calorie target is your TDEE, the equation you just got from the slide before. If you want to be in weight loss, you need to be in deficit. So to be in deficit, you need to be consuming less than your energy expenditure. For a healthy and sustainable weight loss, around 10 to 25% of your TDEE is recommended. Of course, this is going to be based on a variety of factors, from how fast you want to lose weight to what kind of training you're doing, et cetera, et cetera. But for sustainable weight loss while maintaining muscle, you want to be at about 10 to 25% of your TDEE. So take your TDEE, multiply that by 25% on your calculator. That is the calories that you are going to deduct, and that is going to be the deficit that you are going to have every single day. So once you deduct that from your TDEE, that is going to be your calorie target. Those of you that want surplus, you want to go into weight gain or muscle gain, I generally say start with about a 500 calorie bump up from your TDEE and then play around from there. So we're going to set this up at a 40-30-30 macros plan. Again, that's 40% of your diet is in carbohydrates, 30% in protein, 30% in fat. If you are an endurance athlete, you can drop your protein to about 15 to 25% of your diet, which means you will be upping your carbohydrates considerably. Carbs, of course, are the preferred form of energy for your body. So as an endurance athlete, that may be more optimal for you. But for the majority of you, you want to keep your protein between 25 and 35%. So let's put you at 30% in your protein. Carbohydrates, again, these are your preferred source of energy for your body. We want these at 40%. If you're an endurance athlete and you dropped your protein much lower, then you're going to want to take your carbohydrates higher at about 50 to 60%. The bulk of you are going to be somewhere between 35 to 40% of your diet in carbohydrates. So again, let's standardize this at 40% to start, which leaves the remaining of fat somewhere between about 25 to 35% of your daily calorie intake will be from fats. So again, we're going to standardize that at 30%. So how to figure out your exact numbers? Remember the things I told you before. A gram of protein contains 4 calories. A gram of carbs, 4 calories. A gram of fat has 9 calories. So I'm going to use the example of a 1600 calorie diet. And that's going to be the 1600 is going to be the target range that we're figuring out the macros for. So you're going to take your calories for figuring out your protein. You're going to take your calorie target, multiply it by X percent of your protein macro. We discussed 40, 30, 30. So 1600 times 30% equals 480. That is the amount of calories you should be getting from protein on a 1600 calorie diet. Then you're going to divide 480 by 4, which is the amount of calories per gram of protein, to figure out the grams of protein you need daily to be at that target. So for a 1600 calorie diet, doing a 40-30-30s macros plan with protein at 30%, you would want to get 120 grams of protein as your daily target. Same thing for carbohydrates. You're going to redo the equation, only now we're going to take that calorie target and multiply it by 40%, so you can see how many calories you want your diet to come from carbohydrates. In this case, it is 640 calories. You're going to then divide 640 calories by 4, which is the amount of calories per gram of carbohydrate, to figure out how many grams of carbohydrate is your daily target. So in this case, it's 160 grams of carbohydrate for a 1600 calorie diet at a 40% carbohydrate ratio. Same goes for your fats. Remember, your fats are higher in calories per gram. So you're going to take 1600, our calorie target, or whatever your calorie target is, multiply it by the fat percentage you want in your diet. We're going to say 30%. You get 480. That is the amount of calories that are coming from fats. You then divide 480 by 9 this time, which is the amount of calories per gram of fat. And now you get 53. That's 53 grams of fat for your daily target. So if you're at a 1600 calorie target on a 40-30-30 plan with 40% carbs, 30% protein, 30% fat, you're doing 120 grams of protein, 160 grams of carbohydrate, and 43 grams of fat. So you can see these numbers become really individualized based on your equations. So now that you know your calorie targets, you have to think about, and your macro targets, now you have to think about how you're going to chart them. apps like MyFitnessPal and other macros apps can really help you out. If you are eating a processed food, there's always a label on processed food that says the fat, the carb, all of those different contents that are in there that you can, the protein amount that you can be logging. If you're eating a whole food product like green beans, strawberries, bananas, apples, they obviously don't have a label. So you'll need to use those apps to figure out how many macros each one of those has, the fat, the carb, the protein, etc. So again, doing a macros plan does require you to do a little bit more charting, but it also helps you really learn what foods are high in carbs, lower in carbs, high in protein, lower in protein, high in fats, lower in fats, and that gives you a lot more control around the foods you're eating and the results that you're getting. So hopefully this really helps you out. If you know you love the idea of minding your protein, if you love the idea of minding your macros, but you really don't want to weigh your food, count calories, count, you know, macros, fuss with all the apps and all of that, please connect with me about Portion Fix or Ultimate Portion Fix, which are completely plug and play ways to achieve the same goal of a 40-30-30 macros plan. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to reach out. I hope you're having an awesome day, and I hope that you come back to learn more about health, fitness, and wellness with me, and I'll see you guys soon.